Sissy and Aruda. Today I'm going to teach you how to do a sissy squat if you don't have that sissy squat apparatus, if you're at a gym that doesn't have that, here's an option for you, okay? So if you don't already know, you might be wondering what is a sissy squat and why is it named that? Well, it was actually named after Sisyphus, who was a Greek god known for his impressive leg development. So you're going to need a squat rack, and you're going to position yourself in front of the squat rack. I'm using a foam to protect my legs. You can also double up a mat or a yoga mat, whatever you have on hand. So this is great for leg development, glutes. In doing this, okay, you can spot yourself at first, and you want to sit back like you're sitting in an invisible chair. And then you're going to push up. So I'm really emphasizing my weight pushing through the heels, okay? So that's how you start. If you have someone that can spot you behind you, you want to keep your back perfectly flat and as straight as possible, down to a 90 degree angle between your knees and the floor, okay? And that's the basis of the sissy squat, okay? So when you sit back, okay, all right, so you want to kind of some variations of pulsing, okay. Now it's, you know, it's a little daunting doing that, so you may actually just want to kind of use one hand to assist initially, and I like to use the back of the hand because then you're not using so much assistance from your hands that way. So you want to sit back and come up. And sit back, hands, variations, and up, down, and up. Okay, so when you start to load it, grabbing a plate, positioning it and holding it in front of my body, close to my body, and you're gonna sit back down, nice and controlled, and then squeeze. Squeeze the booty on the way up, down, and exhale, a little lift, and up, and there you have it, a sissy squat variation that makes it possible for you to do it, okay, if you don't have that machine. And happy leg training.